As we speak, the NOPD is set to make a major announcement involving a high-profile murder case, a case that has the entire metro area buzzing for the past several days.
Curtis Matthews, you'll remember, was shot and killed in front of the Jazz Daiquiri Lounge on Claiborne. He was the brother of a witness in the Telly Hankton murder trial. This is a live look at NOPD headquarters right now. That news conference set to begin any second. WDSU reporter Sydney Chewitt is standing by for us to wrap things up at the news conference's conclusion. But we expect Police Chief Ronal Serpas to step to that podium in the next couple of seconds.
And Scott, we suspect, we don't know, but we suspect they have made an arrest in the murder of Curtis Matthews, the brother of the witness whose testimony helped send Telly Hankton to prison for life. You're looking at a live picture of the Chief of Police of the New Orleans Police Department, who's walking to the podium right now, ready to begin his news conference.
Good evening. Thank you for being here tonight. As you know, this police department has been focusing its resources untiring since last Saturday night with an around-the-clock effort to put a name and a face with the man who shot and killed Curtis Matthews last Saturday night. I am pleased to say tonight that because of the help of so many New Orleanians, we have done just that. We have issued an arrest this evening for Walter Porter, an African-American male, 31 years old, 6'3", weighing 170 pounds. An arrest warrant has been issued for his arrest, calling him into responsibility for the second-degree murder of Walter Porter. Tonight, less than an hour ago, our special weapons and tactics team and homicide detective served a search warrant on Porter's house based upon the voluminous information we have received from the public. We believe there may be evidence in this search, and we will know more in the coming hours. Once again, the drive-through doors of justice in New Orleans tell us the sad story. Porter has an extensive arrest and conviction history for violent crimes, to include crimes such as burglary, illegal weapons, simple battery, damage to property, putting officers' lives in danger, and convictions for assault, aggravated battery, distribution of marijuana, and felon in possession of a firearm. It's very important that our community know that we are grateful for the continued assistance, untiring assistance, of the District Attorney's Office, the federal law enforcement officers, and the state law enforcement officers who have worked with us every day on this case. But I got to make the point perfectly clear. What Mr. Porter don't know is who's talking. And what we know is a lot of people are talking. What Mr. Porter don't know is who's going to be the one to call us tonight and say where he's laying his head down as he's running from his crime. What Mr. Porter will never know is that tonight the people of New Orleans said, with no doubt, we will talk, we will share, and we will let you know where Mr. Porter is. So rest assured that we will not rest until Mr. Porter is arrested and brought to justice for these crimes. I am incredibly proud of the men and women of the police department, particularly our homicide detectives under the leadership of Chief Boyalis, Commander Noel, and Lieutenant Marchese, who have nonstop worked this case since Saturday. Any questions?
Do we have reason to believe that Mr. Porter has connections with the Hankton family? And if so, what are those connections?
We do believe that there is a relationship between Mr. Porter and members of the Hankton family. The depth of that relationship needs to continue to be investigated. But we also know that the people of New Orleans have a relationship with this police department, and they're the ones who told us so much information about Porter.
Are you looking at what's being done to keep witnesses and their families safe?
That's the best question tonight. This is what's keeping people safe. What makes a community safe is when it stands up with its numbers of 343,000 people and says, we have had enough. We have had enough. I can't stress this point enough. We have received so much information from the public. So much information from the public. Porter has no idea who's calling us. We know who's calling us, and we're not going to defend him, and we are not going to make them get in harm's way because we have so many people calling. It doesn't have to come to that.
Do you believe Curtis Matthews was the target, or was this a case of mistaken identity?
This continues to be considered by our investigations. We do not rule any theories out. We want to make sure that we look at this holistically in partnership with our district attorney and his wonderful staff who've worked so hard with us on this case.
At this point, are you able to say whether you'll leave it to retaliation killing for the conviction of Telly Hankton?
I think right now it's far too soon but it's also far obvious that the connectivity of here cannot be ignored. We don't know the depth of it yet, and we don't know all the facts that we can or can't prove, but the connectivity does strike the question of what relationship existed, and that's what we're going to get to the bottom of.
Can you comment on any threats made to the district attorney and his family, also police protection that we found outside the mayor's home tonight, his parents' home, and also the district attorney's home?
It's standard practice in our business to not comment on security measures and security packages of personnel who we work with, and I'm not going to be at liberty to do so today. We won't confirm or deny either. I have every reason to believe that Mr. Porter has a lot of his friends watching TV tonight, and they don't know which one's going to call us and tell us where he is, but somebody's going to call us and tell us where Porter is.
Do you think that those unspecified threats targeted towards the DA have anything to do with what's happened in the last few days?
No, I think it's important, again, that we don't confirm or deny any of the security packages that we work, and I'll continue to be able to say just that.
Do you think others in the city could be targeted, other citizens, detectives perhaps, in the police department?
You know, one of the reasons being a police officer is such a professional and noble cause is because this goes on every day. We arrest dangerous people in this community every single day. Porter is just one of the many in any city in America. So, no, we don't let ourselves focus on that too much. We're smart. We make sure we do good jobs, but we're not going to let ourselves be distracted by that.
Why are you naming him?
Because we got a warrant for him about 2.5 hours ago, a warrant for his arrest. No, not at all, because the point I made a few minutes ago is that we have received so much information from the people in the city of New Orleans, he has no idea who's been talking to us.
Telly Hankton has been called by the police department one of the most dangerous men in New Orleans. Do you think he's communicating from inside his cell? How is this witness, the brother of the witness, how is this whole thing kind of happening?
We still need to investigate so many things. My predecessor and our predecessor administration of police called him the most dangerous man in New Orleans. I have no reason to believe that that was hyperbole. I have no reason to believe that they didn't have good cause to think so. But tonight is the night to say the truth. Simple truth, plain fact. The people of New Orleans have responded, overwhelmingly have responded that they have had enough. This is how we turn the tide. This is how we protect witnesses. This is how we protect our community. This is how we make New Orleans the great city that Mayor Landrieu and I have committed to making this city be.
I've heard that task forces have been created in light of what has happened. Can you talk a little bit more about that?
We have such an interconnectivity with our local, state, and federal partners that in this particular case, we've gotten assistance from the Louisiana State Police, Colonel Edmondson's team. We've gotten assistance from the FBI, the ATF, the DEA. We've gotten daily work, partnership, and assistance with the district attorney's office. Now, be sure, though, that we do that every day on all types of cases, that this wasn't newly created as a result of the Curtis Matthews case, but it shows that we are already so much lockstep in working together. We shifted resources on this case on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and now here we are Thursday night.
I know that any murder is obviously egregious in this community, but it seems as if this one has offended city leaders a little bit more than most, kind of going back to the Crime Stoppers press conference held a couple of days ago. Would you say that it had a chilling effect or potentially chilling effect on the community if the case wasn't solved?
Now, there are times when a mayor, like Mayor Landrieu did the other day, the district attorney, myself, the sheriff, and so many others come to the community and say, we understand, we hear, we know that people are concerned. And we have a responsibility as public leaders to ensure that that concern is met with a professional, thorough, non-ending response. So that's what was really the important message, is that every murder is a tragic loss to a family in our community. But Curtis Matthews is a man with a family. And he, like the other victims of murder this year, deserve to know that we're going to do everything and anything we can within our power to bring those to justice who commit the crime. And then more importantly, with so much work that Mayor Landrieu is doing and we're doing with strategic command and looking at the bigger issues of how to stop murder as a community holistically.
Do you think this is related to the truck that plowed into the DA's office?
We have no idea if it is or it isn't. We continue to investigate any and all leads on that case. Again, Crime Stoppers is your method. What makes this so exciting for us tonight to be able to name a suspect is that people came to us. And some people came to us through Crime Stoppers, and when you put the two together, you have an overarching amount of information coming in for our detectives to work with. We'd ask for the same thing with the pickup truck. We'd ask for the same thing. People who know something, get in touch with us through Crime Stoppers if you have a reason to be concerned for your safety, or you want to use Crime Stoppers, or call us directly. Either way. Thank you very much.
The police chief of New Orleans with a major announcement tonight. Make no mistake about it, folks. This is a significant development. A suspect has been named in the murder of Curtis Matthews. That suspect is Walter Porter. The police chief describes him as a man with an extensive arrest and conviction history for violent crime in New Orleans. He credits the people of New Orleans with the assist in this particular suspect. In so many words, the chief of police is saying that the people of New Orleans are undeterred by threats of violence and intimidation.